As promised, I am going to do the Adele makeup from last weekend. I'm a huge Adele fan. I got Adele playing in the background. I'm in the mood here. This is what we're doing. Adele, the gold lid, the peachy cheek, the flawless skin, the nude lip, defined brow, wing liner. It's classic Adele. God help me. Okay. I am actually going to not use Saint. Again, a couple weeks ago, I put on my stories, Lady Gaga, who I also love, came out with her new formulation of her House Labs. And I went to Sephora this weekend and I couldn't help myself and I bought my shades, one concealer, one all over foundation for science. I mean, here I am. I love Saint. It is cream-based makeup. It looks like skin. I'm really good at putting it on. It's actually super easy. A monkey could do it. So I'm gonna see if I still got it and I can wear a liquid foundation. So we're gonna try this today and see how it goes. I have one pump on my fingers and I'm gonna just kind of lightly stamp myself. I want like pretty light coverage. I think our fingers are pretty damn good applicators, if you ask me. Just at least to get it going, you know? And put it where it belongs and make sure it's like not too much in any one spot. And then you can pick up your brush. I love these guys, these short stubby ones, because I think they clean off quite a bit of it. And then you're left with just this really thin layer. Now this is the concealer. This is 13 Light Natural. So again, just kind of like putting it in my T-zone. So I think for this Adele look, I mean, obviously this is like a big stage weekend, full glam, full throttle. So, you know, full coverage makeup is what's in store for today. Okay, I'm moving on. I'm gonna do contour and bronzer and everything else with Saint. I have my contour loaded on my brush here. It's gonna go around my hairline, down the sides of the nose here. I usually just kind of like work my way around the face and just dispense the makeup off the brush so that I don't have to go back and like tap in the pan again. It's just the speediest way to do it, in my opinion. So just load the brush and then just kind of work your way around and there you have it. Bronzer. I'm using Fiji. I like to put it on with my finger first because I only want a little bit. And then I'll blend it. I'm really into this brush. It's a BK Beauty brush. It's the 101. Look at this big daddy. Angled, lots of bristles, covers a lot. The density is good. The length of the bristles are good. I love these brushes. These were gifted to me by this company, BK Beauty, and I really like them. Okay, here's a tip for you. If you're a blonde and you get makeup in your hair, take a damp sponge and you can wipe that out of your hairline. Look at that. And then if you need to like do more cleanup, you can take a clean spoolie and just comb through, okay? Because nobody wants that ratchet shit in their hair. Nobody. The first time I heard that song, I had bought her album, the latest one, on vinyl, and I sobbed. I just sobbed and sobbed. Anyway, I wanted to work out the eye look before I came back on so that I could make this speedy for you, but I just had to pause, and that's like my favorite song off of that new album. She's just such a powerhouse, and I know that that song was written out of a tremendous amount of pain, and I can feel that pain, and it's just incredible to see her, like we all do, just move through that pain into something greater. It's incredible. So moving into the eye look, one last thing about the Lady Gaga House Labs concealer is that I do have it on my lid and I found it to be very forgiving primer for the lids, which is kind of hard to come by, I think, when it comes to liquid foundation. Again, the finish is just so lovely and I'm really impressed. So Butterscotch is our first shade. And it's all about feathering and layering, guys. And so wherever you stick the brush down first is where the most payoff and the most pigment is going to sit. So I'm concentrating that on my crease in the outermost part of it. And then as I start to kind of like work it in, I'm gonna start to sweep it a little bit more toward the inner corner. And then I'm just gonna repeat this again and again and again until I get the depth of color that I want over here. It's not gonna take much, but again, it just looks so velvety when you do that and you kind of build the pigment. This is Philly. I'm using a tapered brush, also fluffy, and I'm doing just like that inner pocket of the crease and like kind of the outer corner of the lid. So really being careful not to go too high with this, but I'm starting to build the shape of this wing liner that is gonna be there. So I'm just kind of like paving the road underneath, is so to speak. So I just want the depth right out here in the outer corner. Always important to note too, guys, when you move on to eye number two, your brush is already primed with pigment, so you're not gonna need to pick up quite as much color out of the tin. And less is more, so I already have my foundation on, and this is a pretty big, you know, it's got some darker colors, and I don't want that fall off, so it's important to just really take your time so that you don't mess up the makeup that you've already done, kind of thing. One thing I will say about that is a benefit to cream makeup versus liquid foundation is if I do mess it up, because I'm wearing liquid foundation that has now dried down to like, you know, the finish that it is, it's not emollient like cream-based makeup is. So if I muck it up, I have to take a makeup wipe and wipe the whole thing away and basically start over at the very beginning. Whereas with cream-based makeup, I can just take a clean brush, wipe it away like an eraser, just a little bit, fix it, and then keep moving, and there's no, you know, back to the starting line. So now I'm just taking my two primed brushes, and I would just kind of go back and forth and make sure that one color is beautifully ombre blended into the other, and now that it is, I can also take those brushes and just kind of sneak and tickle my low lashes. I don't want a ton of pigment underneath, just a little. I mean, that's just mascara. We're gonna get to the mascara here soon. I'm so excited, it's a new one. I got it over the weekend and it's so awesome. Okay, also a big fan that when you're working things out in advance and you wanna get it right, especially if you're like replicating a look, definitely swatching colors on your hand is really important. It's like her lid is gold and these are three golds. So on the end here, this is our powder illuminator called Goldie. Then Blondie eyeshadow, almost the same. They just have a little bit different. This is more yellow, this is more champagne. And then over here we have a color called Gold Digger, which is a little more of a copper, dark gold. Okay, so I actually used Gold Digger on the outer corner and then worked my way in with Blondie. So I've got those two here to show you. Gold Digger and Blondie. Okay, you see the difference? I used one brush and I just used like one side and then the other. It is a brush that has like a curved taper to it and it's very flat. So it's gonna mimic like my fingertip. And I'm using that on purpose because I wanna cut. Now, shimmers can be just as treacherous to your foundation makeup as the darker colors can. So if you get fall off even with the glitters, that can be problematic as well. So I'm taking my time. I'm just picking up a little pigment and then I'm covering my lid. I want the opacity pretty dense. So this is Blondie. I'm gonna flip the brush over, pick up Gold Digger and do the outside corner. Same thing, cutting it in and just blending one into the other. And then we will put our wing liner on. I like this idea that one blends into another. It creates even more dimension. I don't know why I always do this to myself, but I should do this one so that I'm not having to cross when I do the for the video. You know what I'm saying? If I did it over here, then you'd have a clear view versus me being like this, trying to do the wing liner. But hey, this is where we're at today, so. Okay, this pen is a Physician's Formula. It is a drugstore brand, and it is a nice pen. So I'm gonna start with my eye open. Hope you can see. Very light touch. And then running that across my lash line. And then to do the wing, again, you're just gonna imagine the imaginary line goes from the corner of your eye out here to this imaginary line at the end of your brow. Start with that. You see what I'm doing here? Straight line, and I'm filling it in. When you realize it's a straight line, it becomes so easy. So, out, back. And then to do the inner corner, just keep your eye open and look straight ahead. Simple as that. This is no, I know influencer people, I don't really consider myself one of them, but influencer types say that they're obsessed with everything and it waters down the opinion that they have of everything because they're making money on it. I'm not making any money on this, I promise you. I was gifted this to try. It is the YSL Lash Clash Mascara. Thought I had tried them all. This is so good. So good. Usually I get scared when I see these like giant caterpillar spoolie wands, but my God, the pigment is perfect. The separation is perfect. The wand is nice and full. You can just blink right down on it. I usually like two coats on the top, but one coat on the bottom is just enough. Just zigzag that bad boy. And I really, really like it. Okay, y'all know that my other pet peeve that I have besides makeup in the hair is having a big weft on the top lash. I love a strip lash, I love a fake lash, I love removable lashes, but I cannot take when you blink down and you just see this like piece of yarn that's on the top of your lash. It's just not cute to me. It's a pet peeve. These are underneath install lashes by Flutter Habit. This one is the Wink Kit Set. In the inner corner, I'm just putting a couple individuals. These are by Tatty Lashes. They're just tiny little fans. And I just like a few little sparse ones that are nice and short to fill in that middle, that inner area. These are so natural looking. They're tapered, they fan out. They're installed underneath. You can't see the weft. Look, Russ, you can't see the line. Okay, hope you're learning. Also, today is the start of eyeshadow school. I should probably mention that. So I've used these four shades right here, Butterscotch, Philly, Gold Digger, and Blondie. If you buy four eyeshadows today, you get a free little square compact with your purchase. So on her cheeks, she's got a pretty peachy cheek, but it has a hint of pink to it. So my initial thought was Hollywood. I haven't worn Hollywood in forever. It is the cream dupe to the NARS Orgasm cult favorite. So I'm gonna start with this, and then I might add just a little bit of Frenchie depending on how we do here. So just a fluffy brush about building to that right level. I always try to start with as little as possible and then building from there. But this, honestly, you guys, adding blush just brings the whole look home. Like I looked like Skeletor before this. So this might just be all we need. It's so lovely. God, Hollywood is lovely. If you don't have this color, go get it. Holy crap. It is like the universally flattering blush for any shade, for any skin tone, truly. I skipped ahead and I put lip liner on. It's Iconic Nude by Charlotte Tilbury. It's the most iconic. I love it. It's amazing. I gotta get another one. Glamazing. So one thing to note about the Hollywood, like the NARS blush, it has its own little bit of gold shimmer to it. It's one of the only ones that we have in our lineup that has a shimmer, besides like Sunshine State, which I believe is just lip only. But for cheeks, Hollywood has its own glow to it. So you don't necessarily need to add any more, but I, again, I'm just going off of the photo of what Adele has here, and I'm using a very small brush and glamazing. So I get that megawatt shine just very carefully placed here, top of the nose, tip of the nose, Cupid's bow, and that's about it. And then we're gonna do some lip situation. Okay, I've been getting these amazing gifts from YSL in the mail. Perfumes, mascaras, these Rouge Volupt lipstick balms. If you know, you know. These are so hydrating and so yummy. They have a great payoff of color. So I've swatched all three of them on here. This is the original one that I had before, which is number 150. And then these two just came. This is 44 is this one here, and that's nude. And then this one is 162 Pulsing Rose Hip. over here. So all three of them could work for this look, honestly. I think I'm just gonna try this one nude to see what happens because it's the lightest of the three. When you think luxurious lipstick, this is it. I just sprayed myself with setting spray, like a lot, to lock it in for the day. I'm just gonna fan myself, and then I will probably put on a little bit of powder. I'm gonna use the Makeup Forever Twist and Shine. This stuff is really cool. The packaging's really cool. It dispenses it. I'll show it to you. It's like three different pigments in one, and you just kind of twist it a couple times, and it puts exactly the right amount of these three colors that somehow make sense in the bottom. You use a fluffy brush like this. And I'm just gonna use this really primarily in my like T-zone where I don't wanna be super shiny. That's it. All right, let's see how we did. Let's check our picture. I look just like her. You can say it. Okay, here she is and here I am. This was a long tutorial, no lie. So if you hang in there, I don't even know why you're here in the first place, to be honest. But I love this makeup. I would wear this makeup. I kind of don't want to ever wash my face again. So if you want a color match, I will put the link right here. You can work with me directly. I'll take a look at your face, recommend colors for you. I know we used a lot of non-Saint products today. Which was a fun experiment. I love trying new things, but I find that Saint still, I return to it always because it's the most affordable, the most convenient, the most travel worthy, the most versatile, the most skin-like, and it's just simple. So I love doing these fun tutorials to try to recreate celebrity looks, but for my everyday, Saint's the way.